richer than the rich, we ain't poor no more. I ain't been back in a minute, that's crazy. I ain't seen around, no car, don't page me. Pull up on your block and you ever try to fade me. Calm down, all good, baby, it's gravy. I ain't been back in a minute, that's crazy. I ain't seen around, no car, don't page me. Pull up on your back, don't you ever try to fade me. Calm down, all good, baby, it's gravy.
Good evening. I am Dirt Nigga, the Woody Wiggler. welcome, everybody, to Just a Dope Ass Podcast on this lovely Monday evening. You hear the vibes. This is the sound of outside in Africa. The sound of outside in Africa, God damn it. We have been waiting so long. Rolling Loud is upon us.
Well, they out there fucking just on top of one another.
And
Delta variant, Alpha variant. Heard it was a Q variant out there. Shit, down. It's variants.
All types of variants.
They all there.
They all there.
Loki out there.
The black variants, the white variants. Every variant of everything is out there.
Pretty much.
And soon enough, after that, Kang is going to be upon us as well.
It looks like it, because it was just like...
Every variant is there? Okay, great. You know what happens now, right?
That was just funny, like, all the variant talk, and then whenever you see any footage, it's like, oh, it's a fucking just ocean, sea, just blah, motherfuckers on top of each other.
Sweaty.
Don't anybody go like, that's Florida. That's all you niggas took flights. All y'all was out there.
Everybody.
Just fucking lathered on top of it.
Lathered is. That is a nice term for it. It's a whole lot worse than that. But yeah, it's a lot going on out there. I'm not mad at it. I mean, y'all enjoy. This is what you guys have been waiting for all year long. You finally got the opportunity to go out there and.
I'm not mad about it Rolling Loud. Like, not for real. Like, I don't know if I've got, like, the patience to go to, like, festival after festival. Festivals make sense to me. Like, oh, yeah, you can go out here and, like, kind of go for it, depending on what your preferred festival and shit is. Some people I don't give a shit about. I remember looking at, like, the lineup for this. There was, like, I don't know, for the money I would have had to pay, like, it was just too much, too many niggas I didn't care about. That's
normally the case.
Like, I'm definitely cool with, like, you know, you doing whatever you want to do to go enjoy. But it's just like, man, I want more that I give a shit about. I don't even need it to be all the, like, you know, deep black brother. Like, no, we can get to the bullshit. I just want the bullshit I care about. It was just something up there I didn't give a shit about.
On average for festivals, when you look at the rosters, what's the percentage of acts that you'll say you care about? Like, just on average.
I think, like... on average, I think you might get a hot 40%.
Oh, okay. That's a little bit higher than I was expecting.
Like, I'm assuming, if you have, like, an open ear, like, if you're going, like, specific, it might be lower. But if you're like, oh, okay, I don't like their whole catalog, but they got 5 or 6. This motherfucker I really, really fuck with. If it's after, like, the 5 or 6 person, then it kind of goes into, who is this? And I'm not even talking about openers you don't know. You just on the page. Like, I don't care about, like, the third row down. Like,
the fine print at the bottom?
Yeah. Those would be the good ones, though, when you can find, like, I feel like sometimes you end up going to those, like, I feel like the only time you go and it's, like, a hit after hit after hit is when you go to, like, those, I don't know, like, if Soul Action was to put on, like, a fucking, because then it's, like, 500, you didn't know the 500 motherfuckers that was already up there on the ticket. You don't know the motherfuckers that are coming up, but you know what, they just mesh this music together well. But also, those would be, like, you know, 200 motherfuckers from, like, SoundCloud that just are like, I'm doing this for the love. I'm like, I can hear it.
And they're not bringing out as many clouds. But shout out to Soul Action and Joker. Hey, Joker, you can make that happen. And you can invite us to, like, host it if you want.
I'm okay with that.
I'm okay. I'm completely okay with that.
I'm not even sure what I would say. I would just be up there like, I'm really happy to be here, guys. Aren't you all? Like,
just awesome.
Let's all just sway and be in love together.
flowy music. There's just a good vibe all day. I don't know half y'all name, but I know the music is enjoyable because Joe K don't put no bull. I'll take that back. Maybe 10% of the shit he plays, I'd be like, eh. But 90% is great.
Yeah.
That is amazing. But I feel like it's, when you look at, talking about the fine print, I feel like it's the big print artists I really don't care about. Like, more times than not, that's the percentage that I'd be like, eh. They're not included in the 40. It's people that are more so in the fine print. They're like, oh, okay, see.
That's a good point.
I can rock with that. Because they're going to pick the biggest names that are going to make the most money, which means they're going to be the most commercial success, which I don't.
Yeah, I mean, I know that, like, music is in a different space where you can have somebody who's super successful and be like, whatever. But in the general sense, like, yeah, I ride with that. It just is like, oh, you're on the radio a lot. This might be trash.
Yeah.
Although music has taken like a big fucking, there's been a lot in the music space to get today, which, to preface, I don't find the song to not be sonically pleasing. Lil Nas X broke the internet again, you guys, and the people are mad because, I don't know, the gay dude did some gay shit or whatever. Like, he's out there being gay, and it's like, but he is gay. Like, so,
duh.
You know, I mean, I don't really know, like, the big thing is, like, he's still in his early 20s, so the fuck is at an all-time high. And it's also, a good point was made, it's like, the last video, bro was throwing ass on Satan. Like,
it's only up from here.
Yeah, like, what could possibly, and I know, like, my only gripes with this little recent video was just that I just felt like the prison thing is not cool. I don't like when niggas do the prison shit, period. Right. Like, I just was like, oh, the prison bitch thing, I don't think is like a, I am gay, you know. The last video made more sense to me. It was like, oh, you know, you Christian people have been telling me, like, my existence is trash. Well, have some get back, bitch. I was like, all right, I can understand that. The prison gay thing, I'm just like, ah, that's usually looked at as, now, I don't know, I've never been to prison. Now, if somebody's telling me, like, you know, it's super lit and it's not, like, you know, I prefer jelly a motherfucking syrup. Like, you know, if that ain't it, then, you know, maybe my bad. But other than that, I just looked at that, like, for 2 seconds. I was like, oh, that's a bit, like, probably more traumatizing to, like, our experience, period. Because that's not like, oh, I'm gay. That's like, you know, that's usually identified as like, oh, you niggas in here getting raped. That's not fun.
Yeah.
But other than that, I mean,
so
like,
it's a lot to it that you can really dive deep into if you really want to find an issue with it. I found my little issues watching it the one time that I watched it just to see what everybody was upset about. No replay value for me, obviously. It's not something that I want to watch. It's not for me, but I'm not going to hate it. I do. The only thing I really, really found an issue with, which makes sense, but I still found an issue with it, was like, all the inmates are black.
Yeah.
Not the, even them dancing naked choreographed stuff in the background. That wasn't even tripping, but like when
he thought that was funny as fuck.
I mean, it's
that was ridiculous.
It was super over the top and unnecessary, but I expect that from him. I expect him to go that far, so I'm not surprised by that. If it was somebody else, I'd be like, come on now. That's a bit much. For him, it's like, I expect you. I know you're doing this on purpose. You're trying to find a way to top the last video. So that part I didn't care about. But when the riot breaks out, one, all the inmates are black, which when it comes to representation for us, trying to avoid any negative connotations to our people, I wouldn't want to make everybody in the jail black. The only white person in the video is what's-her-face, and he's the only straight person. Representation-wise, I get it, but come on now. If we're going to have a prison video, don't make everybody in prison us. And they're running around at the end rioting, raping the guards. Like, come on, man. Like, at least throw some sprinkles of other races of people in there. Don't fit the stereotype and make everybody us.
Yeah, but also, I can't give, like, him that hard a time because we all just rep this as, like lyrical talent and everything, but we just...
Sit down, bitch, and move again. I'll beat the shit out of you. Don't make me wake this baby. She don't need to see what I'm about to do.
This is, this was...
Why you always make me shout at you?
And this is one of many.
Just leave me and love him out the blue.
And then you got the song to it.
Am I too loud for you? Too bad, bitch. You're gonna find...
For the record, guys, if you hadn't, you know, if y'all are a little younger than when this album dropped... Like, he killed, this is a murder.
So I don't wanna go.
And it was just like, they love this shit. Like,
I mean, it gave the crazy white boy something to be like hyped about. I mean, we enjoyed it as black people too, but I think we let it slide. It's like, oh, that's a white dude, and we expect that from them. Just kind of like the gay stuff, we expect that from Lil Nas X. So I'm not really tripping. So
yeah, I was wondering why there was so many like, and I'd be trying not to, you know, get super social justice-y with the hip hop people, but like, it's hypocritical as shit to just for niggas to get any type of issue about it. I don't know if the baby statements was made about him, but
I don't think so.
Yeah, I didn't think so either. I felt like people were like kind of.
I think they found a way to tie that in because it was just timing for the both of them. But I think he was just addressing like,
yeah, my honest,
like, suspect you, stuff in general. Like, I don't think he cares if you're gay. You're expected to do that. I think he's talking about people that are sneaking, doing it, and hiding.
Yeah,
it.
In my mind, yeah, he found out somebody like that they knew was like sucking dick in the parking lot. I'm going to put it on stage. Now, is there a conversation where that was probably unnecessary? Absolutely,
most definitely.
But yeah, I mean. Even like T.I.'s little rant, I would just be like, I don't know, I'm not that famous, but I'm just like, I don't like it. That boy gay, like, but I don't know what T.I. said either.
T.I. was basically saying the same thing. He's like, I'm just, everybody has an opinion, because he was kind of defending DaBaby a little bit, basically just saying like that's his preference if he wants to say what he has to say. He didn't say it directly to Lil Nas X, but it's his preference if he don't like that. It's the same for me. I don't care that the boy's gay. I don't care what he has in his video. It's not for me, and I have the right to say that it's not for me and it's not my thing. I don't hate him for it. Just because I don't prefer it or I don't like it, it doesn't mean that I hate him or that I hate gay people, just like anybody else. That's just not my preference.
So is there an argument where, like, it could be made that you could definitely say you don't like it, it's not your cup of tea, and be perfectly fine, where people can go like, hey man, how come y'all niggas will never be this vocal about a nigga on his 17th shoot that nigga in his face and fucking rob and what, like, hey man, you ain't on no, like, you ain't got one Build the Block Up song or some shit, or like just some genuine party shit.
I mean, that's, I think that's why T.I. may feel like he has realms to speak, because he balances it out. But he's one of very few artists that'll actually balance it out. Not just like one song per album that's positive. He'll have at least 4, 5, 6 of them joints on there that are talking. Especially recently, he'll have something on there talking about empowerment. And then he'll have a couple Throw That Ass songs on there. And a couple I'm T.I. and Still Street Nigga songs on there. So he balances it out. But I think that may give him more realms to talk over somebody else that's just 100%. This, that, and the other, blah, blah, blah. But he had some valid points. People were just upset because it's T.I.
Yeah, it's not. He's still in, like, fucking DEFCON 5 zone with his situations and whatnot.
I haven't heard anything about that in a while.
I mean, I know the court system works how it works, but there's been a couple things that have been a little quiet in the streets, and, you know, I don't know.
I don't know either. But for that, like, if it's... To me, if it becomes really, really quiet and people start talking about it, that means the person that you were trying to, like, demonize because of the situation is probably in the right.
I always wonder, like, I know we've talked about this before, but, like, when does there come to be, like, a culture of even an apology, but definitely a, if you, and I'm not saying bro is, like, out of the woods, but in general, you can just say something about somebody. And I know everybody throws around the world word allegedly to keep themselves, whatever, but the fact that you can just say something and, like, it sticks to somebody's right. Shit. And it's like, okay, I mean, like, you know, definitely investigate, definitely do your due diligence. But if it comes out that this motherfucker said they lying on me and they was lying on him, what happens to those that lie on them?
Like, absolutely nothing. The same thing that happens to the person that got lied on. Nothing happens. They just get to be able to see, I told y'all. But people still going to look at them and be like, mm. Same with Bill. Look at Bill.
Yeah.
People hate Bill, but, like, when you look at the facts of the case, what did he do other than provide the vibes? And they accepted it. And even a lot of them recanted their stories and, like, but we still, Bill DePeel and all, we're still saying the same things when actually it's like, no, that's, he admitted to providing the vibes, but everything else was not the case.
Yeah, I'm not, Michael. Yeah, I'm not for, like, absolving somebody of wrongs they did, but I don't know. It is a weird culture of, like, just pouring it on. It's like, that's not what that was. Like, you can get them for what they did, but you don't gotta pour it on either. Like,
absolutely not. Speaking of pouring it on, I'm not too thrilled about them pouring it on R. Kelly.
He poured it on. I couldn't even get that one off.
You couldn't get it out.
It's about pee.
I mean, that's not really pouring it on. You have to put it in something. But my issue with that is, like, he's already in jail. Mm-hmm. Why are you guys trying to find more stuff to pin on him when there's tons of other white people that are doing worse than him that we don't hear anything about?
I mean, definitely the poster child thing. I think also definitely there's this goddamn thing with us about getting caught up in, like, the example or the one, whether it's good or bad, and not taking the whole thing, the whole structure of it,
right,
and taking that on. But, yeah, I do think there's just still, like, a funniness or entertainment quality to talking about Robert shit, as opposed to, like, if we're gonna take down motherfuckers like being weird pedos, then do that for real. Because I saw a post even this week that was spoke to, like, basically saying, like, how quick in our community we're bigger to jump on homosexuality than we are to jump on, you know, Uncle such and such. To where, you know, I forget who said that joke, but it was like, I told y'all ass to stop going back there. Walk it off, goddamn it. Then.
I forgot who that was.
Yeah, and it was just like, that's a joke, but that's also, jokes speak highly about, like, real lived experiences. And it's like, yeah, we should definitely take the motherfuckers out back and, like, flog them to death, but we don't. It's just, you know, you keep Uncle, you know, Silas just in watching distance, but nobody ever does anything about him. But you got a cousin who just so happens to be gay. And you just fucking condemn him or whatever. Or you gotta.
When it comes to it being close to home, most people feel so shamed about it and they're worried about their personal image, even though they're not the one perpetuating their behavior, that they're willing to sweep it under the rug but demonize somebody else for it. If you have said family member that is gay, it's easier to be like, ugh. Not that they're even doing anything wrong, but it's easy to just be like, ugh. Especially if it's, say, you're from a traditional whatever for your culture. Let's say a traditional Latino family. You're a gay man, the only boy, which means you ain't carrying the line name. So now you really feel some way about this decision that your child has made. I can disagree with you all day long and be upset about it, but I'm not going to talk about your uncle who was touching you when you was little. Not to say that that's the reason you became gay, but who knows? Maybe that could be a contributing factor. We don't know. That goes into a mental health space of how they were internalizing love and what love was supposed to mean and things of that nature. But you don't want to address that, or the mental health for that matter. But you're going to demonize this person's behavior, their choices. That's not cool. I don't understand that. But that kind of goes along the lines of us pointing the finger and scapegoating, say, Robert. Not to say that he shouldn't be whatever for his wrongdoings, but this somebody we know has been through a trauma. We know has been through all these significant behaviors done unto him growing up throughout his lifetime. And then we just continuously find ways to shit on him. But these other people that are actual predators,
yeah,
we not doing nothing. We're treating them like Uncle So-and-so and sweeping them under the rug.
Like, we talk about Weinstein, but Weinstein's still not talked about with the fucking venom in their voice, like, that they talk about.
At all.
Or fucking
Kevin. When I was gonna say Kevin Bacon, but not Kevin Bacon. My fault. Sorry, Kevin.
I was about to say, man, I wouldn't be surprised.
What's the other dude name? The actor. God damn it. Kevin Spacey.
Oh yeah. Him, exactly. And I love that show. Like,
we don't talk nothing about Spacey.
He fell under the radar. People don't talk about, like, the life and times of Hugh Hefner just because he was Hef.
At all.
But Hef was, like, kidnapping bitches and shit and doing some, like, real overt weird shit. It was, what was it, just fucking, we talked about it on here, what, 3-4 months ago? That nigga Armie Hammer was alleged to be chewing on bitches and shit. And that just disappeared. Like, they don't talk about that shit no more. Nobody said heads or tails as to whether it was, like, wrong, right, confirmed, unconfirmed. It just was,
That's all it was. You got a blip on the radar, and that was it, and they sweeped it underneath the rug. We never talk about Elvis. White people still love Elvis, say he the king, but we ain't talking about his underage endeavors that he participated in. We still herald, what's old white dude with the glasses that was a movie director, producer, that married his...
Oh, fucking Woody...
Woody Allen.
Nasty motherfucker.
We don't talk about him, but he was at one point in time, and still maybe for some, is one of the best directors. These guys get to keep their title for their accomplishments, even though we know that they were doing some predatory, grooming, nasty shit. Robert over here is just being a sexual individual, even though, you know, the underage situation is not cool.
It's gross. I mean, we could throw Robert away. Just throw everybody away.
That's what I'm saying. Like, yeah. we don't look at... Should we still listen to R. Kelly? Should you watch Kevin Spacey movies? Should you watch any of the movies that Harvey Weinstein walked? Like,
y'all why? Still saying that Kaiser Soze shit. Man, he might have been getting his shit off back then. Like, he just got old and became a weirdo.
Most definitely. So, I would want to prosecute everybody as opposed to jumping on... I don't want to say innocent people because we're lumping the LGBTQ community in here. I don't want to attribute them to Robert because Robert's not innocent. Mm-hmm. He's just the scapegoat, which I'm not cool with. But these people that either are innocent or they've been through trauma and that caused them to make certain behaviors, I'm not cool on jumping on them to save all the other people who are doing a whole lot worse. That's not cool to me.
Yeah, I'm not. I don't like that being called like sidestepping. And I mean, you know, and it's also up to people to present their arguments because there's a gigantic group of people that like places that argument as a way to just absolve Robert. It's like, nah, nigga, burn that nigga too, but just don't make it like it's just him. Like he's some special case.
Right.
He's the most famous and most talented out of the group, but
and black, which is That's the main reason why we gonna jump on the black. We want the black dude to be the face so we can ignore all these white dudes that are being worse. But even in our community, jumping on gay artists or whatever the case is and demonizing their behaviors, but we still bigging up Future.
Yeah, like that's another thing like about like the weird picky and choosiness about what is, I don't know, you know, you can live his shoe, but I just ain't. But it's like, man, y'all having weird spaces to be like morally sound because I'm not even trying to be like, you know, super Captain Liberal, but it's like, at the end of the day, that boy talking about, say if it just, it's the goddamn agenda to suck a dick. Okay, like, I hear you. I hear you. But your man's put out his 7th song about laying out the block, and like, those niggas is dead and can do nothing for our community.
Or getting super duper high and drugging up women and having sex with them when you got 80,000 kids behind you as well, like,
and there is a difference because I feel like, you know, everybody uses the same excuse. There's a difference between like expressing and turning your experience into art and then just glorifying the dumb shit. You niggas be 5 or 6. I'm talking about my life, nigga. That ain't been your life for like a while. Like,
not only that, but you only chose that life because you didn't feel like doing nothing else. You didn't feel like trying the quote-unquote right way. And part of you wanted to be a rapper, so you thought that that's what you had to do to make sure you got notoriety as a rapper. Whereas this person that's homosexual, lesbian, bisexual, fluid, whatever the fuck it is that they want to be, they're actually living their life. But we're turning our nose up at them for expressing themselves.
Yeah, I wonder what is that thing with certain artists, I should say, where it's like not paying attention to that the bag is not that you have to stay this type of artist or stay. It's that we enjoy, motherfuckers, I think, just enjoy authenticity.
Right.
Like, I was fucking with him when this motherfucker was talking about blah, 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 getting out the trap. Now you're out of the trap. Okay, that's cool. Even if it's like sounds like some, you know, gloaty type whatever. Like, oh, the nigga is on the PJ. Like, I can hear that because that's where he's at in his music.
Right.
This motherfucker is giving away blah, 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 and now is a Kanye who's living in a fucking in the Mercedes-Benz Stadium. But people can just are trying to. I just needed to segue into that. But, like, yeah, you know, like, I feel like artists got to kind of get into the bag of even him, you know, like, people, I think, are at least trying to identify with truth. And it's like, okay, man, if you're a weird artist genius of our time, then we're going to give you space to have a listening party for an album that's probably not even going to be the album, but we're all going to pay stupid amounts of money to come into this fucking stadium, regardless of how much it costs to probably turn that stadium into a weird tarp of a place, but it probably really costs a lot of money when they could just maybe lay down some rugs. And now we don't have the album, but whatever, art.
I mean, think about it this way. The Mona Lisa, one of the most known portraits ever, paintings ever, right? There's only one of those. There hasn't been many reprints of those, right? That person presented it this one time, and you can only see it when you go to see it presented wherever the fuck it's presented.
I saw that thing on a t-shirt over in Venice.
People do that all the time. But as far as the actual painting, so from artistry purposes, how do we know that him releasing the album at the Mercedes-Benz Stadium was that's it. That's the album. You wanted the album? Here's the album. I'm not putting it up for you to stream it because it still got streaming numbers with him playing it there. It still did what it would normally do if he released it on a platform. So I'm having this event, and those that are here, you're going to be the only ones to ever hear this.
I wouldn't be surprised. Like, I just feel like, although there can be obvious, like, debates or conversations, arguments, if you will, out there about his level of genius and his level of, you know, mental illness and his level of, you know, taking advantage of either one. Because those exist. You know, not minimizing anybody's experience, but there are people who are like, hey, I got a thing, or people think I got a thing. So that gives me kind of maneuverability to do some weirdo shit. Like, even if it's like, okay, I'm not having like a moment, but I know the people are like fucking fanatical about me, especially when I get in like an art bag, air quotations.
Right.
So I want to maximize on this album as much as possible. I'm finna go into a fucking divorce, you know? Like, so pay to come into this motherfucking arena and it not drop, then pay for some other shit, probably merch and whoever knows the fuck else, motherfucker's shoes probably went up tenfold that night. And then now I'm gonna re-release, and the re-release is probably gonna come with another fucking thing that people are gonna throw money at, and it's like, yeah, pay me. And the world is gonna pay because he's fucking Kanye.
Of course.
Yeah.
It's a business move, and I'm not mad at it. But if you think about it, most of the quote unquote geniuses that created masterful pieces of art throughout history, they've all done something nuts. They've all had some sort of issue with them, and they have these stories that help propel whatever projects they were working on, even to the point of suicide, some of them.
Yeah. I mean, and I like to, as much as, you know, because I think he does catch a lot of, like, fuck this nigga-ness, which I can't say is unwarranted, but I do have to end up leaning in my own mind. I'm like, just so I can give this a shot, maybe he's finally having, like, an actual honest expression of all this pain and turmoil, because everybody's running joke is that post his mother's passing is when he just jumped off the deep end.
Right.
So maybe Donda can bring him some type of closure or something.
Yeah. I would say more a transition than closure. But
there we go. Something like that.
Something along those. It's giving him something. It's helping him express whatever the fuck. And just allow him to express that. It's kind of the same concept with what we've been speaking on. Somebody is expressing themselves authentically, or at least we perceive it to be authentic, and we demonize them for it because it's not the other things that we deem acceptable.
Yeah. I mean, I had a couple of conversations about it, like, this week, and it was, because I feel like sometimes, too, it's just because somebody is, like, that level of famous, they can get things done quickly. Like, you can have an idea, and where you and me might come up with an idea, it's like, okay, we have an idea today. It might take us 3 months to put that in. He can act, I have an idea, and I can get that put into play tonight. So it was like the Shikari thing. It's like, is that pandering? And it's like, I don't know, man, because he might have really been fucking with her, and he just has the Kanye-level reach.
Right.
To make it make sense, because he's like, I'm in a space and I believe this is wrong, as opposed to I'm going to, you know, make sure that black women are on my side, because black women are on my side, black women listen to music, niggas going to fuck with it, and then the world's going to fuck with it because black people is fucking with it.
I think Kanye actually cares and gives a shit. I think people just bypass what he's actually saying just because it's him. We know that you struggle with this bipolar situation. We know all these personal aspects of your life. So we just throw caution into the wind when it comes to you. Whatever, this nigga up here talking crazy, as opposed to actually listening. I don't think Kanye's ever said anything where it's like, oh, he doesn't give a shit. No, Kanye actually cares and is well thought out, but we shit on him because it's Kanye. We may not agree with the surface level understanding of what we have when he's saying.
Like, I know we got in here and like went for broke on that fucking Joe Rogan pod, but that was a good episode of trying to understand Kanye. And it's like, okay, you go back and listen to certain things that are, you know, somebody took a, I think I'm sensitive to it also being on, like, the long-form pod radio space. It's like, oh, okay, he was talking for, like, an hour, and somebody took 30 seconds of that hour and just threw it out there. It's to where some of them is like, yeah, you could have really just said that better, but there's some things, and I was like, it's almost unfair to put this out there without the full context.
Right.
Because, like, he said on that fucking, and I think this might be for any artist in a particular field, like, you know, there's... How did he say it? When he was like, you know, I think if you correlate thoughts to colors, everybody's pretty much primary colors. Some people are only damn, they're just black and white. And him going, I sometimes know that I think in colors that I can't even explain yet. And I was like, that's probably an artist thing, period. Because I just refuse to believe that when a motherfucker was coming up with an Inception or Tenet, that to explain that to somebody out of your mouth is going to be like, oh, yeah, that makes sense. Time and dreams. But it's like, bitch, just wait till I put this shit on camera, and then it'll make sense.
Most definitely. And it's kind of the same concept with the Lil Nas X situation. Like, we're reacting to what we're seeing on screen, but we're not paying attention to the lyrics of the song. Like, you're bypassing the actual creativeness. Like, yeah, he's... I figured out a long time ago that he enjoys trolling. Mm-hmm. Even on this, so like, he knows that the trolling is going to keep him attention. He's going to keep his name in your mouth. And that's what's going to continue to make him successful. So I'm not mad at that. But listen to the lyrics of the song. He's telling you his truth in that. He's expressing an actual reality that you're bypassing because you're... There's choreographed black man dancing naked in the background. He's like, I'm doing this shit because y'all was fucking with me till you found out I was gay. Now you're demonizing me for every single thing that I do. So I'm going to give you a reason to demonize
it. It's a weird thing with people like getting mad at motherfuckers for being who they are, like, look at this gay boy being gay. It's like, well, yeah, man. What did you think? Like,
right.
He's gonna, and while there is obviously conversations, kind of like we talked about on Saturday, like there's definitely conversations where, you know, you can do the agenda is out here to poison the minds of our youth. And okay, got it. And that's not 100% wrong, depending on the scenario. But also, bitch, are you not home?
Right.
Like, it was shit that I would, and you could tell, and as you get older, you can tell the shit that your parents are saying, that's bullshit because generationally I can't understand it. And then you go, nah, mom and pop said a point. This is just bullshit. Like, you niggas is really stupid.
Right.
And then it's like, okay, cool. Like, there's been tons of shit where niggas be like, oh, niggas is on that. I'm not on that. Just because I was talking, like, there's nothing reason to be on that. You niggas weird.
That was kind of T.I.'s point. Like, T.I. was like, the video's not for me. You know, he went on to talk about Cardi B's WAP video. He's like, that's not for me either. Of course, I enjoyed it more as a straight man because there's things in it that I like. But I didn't, you know, take to it the same way I don't take to this video simply because I don't want my kids looking at it and I'm not going to have my kids watching it. That doesn't mean that I hate you because it's not for me or it's not something that I would present to my family. I can support you doing your thing, but just not within this context. That doesn't mean that I hate you. Which you should be able to compartmentalize or draw some boundaries around what you're doing. That boundary doesn't mean you hate an individual, and it doesn't mean that you should be hating somebody simply because you have a boundary. Mm-hmm. Now, is it a boundary or a bias? That's another question that you kind of have to look at. Because for some people, we'll say, that's my boundary. Like, no, you're being somewhat, you know, you're discriminating.
Yeah.
Big time. You have a bias, and you don't want to admit that you have a bias because you know there's some shame that's going to come with that, as opposed to having an actual boundary, which I accept that, but not within the context of this.
Yeah, and, like, I get that, like, there's... I mean, it's both sides, because there's lanes where you have people that might say the T.I. thing, and they're really just coming from a space of, I don't like motherfuckers doing the gay in front of me. And that's terrible. But there's also people on the flip side who are like, you know, you condemn anybody who says anything remotely that sounds different than, it's like, nah, man, like, I really, you can do whatever you want. I have no interest in seeing two naked niggas. Like, so what do you want? No, man, you can be naked with your niggas. Just, I don't care to see you naked with niggas. What the fuck? You don't want to watch me walking around here just slathered up with titties? You want to see some just big, greasy titties? No, that's not for you. You're not a bad person for that. You just don't like big titties.
Right.
Fuck.
My mama loved me. She may not like how vulgar we can be sometimes on the show, but that don't mean that she hates us or the show.
Yeah, my mom hates this. My mom hates how we discuss shit on the show, but she'll enjoy that what we discussed on the show. Right. Actually, that's half of y'all that just don't like how we said what we said, but...
The presentation.
Fight me, nigga. Because it just, that's...
You can pull up. Saturdays or Mondays, you can pull up if you really just like it that much.
You know
much.
What I don't... This is a complete fucking segue from nothing. Because here's the thing with y'all. It's like, keep it real or enjoying that conversation, like in personal conversation, this, that, and the third. So what the fuck is it that when we get here and do the exact same thing, the fuck your problem? You know, what if that shit you like ain't cool, bitch? Like, yes, you know, and I just, that's it. It ain't no big deal. You just like dumb shit. That's right.
That's a bias. But that kind of goes back to the post that we both put up, you know, on my page and on the pod page, as far as like the women and men, like not changing for a man is looked at as a positive thing. A man not changing for a woman is looked at as a negative thing. It's the same exact behavior. But why is there a bias?
Yeah, because see, here's the thing that, and I know, like, I feel like our critiques come from, obviously, we're dudes and we say things towards women.
We're misogynists!
Yeah, that's a problem. But one, I mean, and this is not like trying to make excuse for a bias. I know what it feels like to be on the man side of things. So right. I have more to talk about towards womenship, but I don't get mad at women shows for like bringing men to the table. It just be women shows don't be saying shit like, Women are fucked up too. And like, seriously say it. Don't just like, you know, we have our problems as well. Whoa, explore those. Cause I don't feel like we don't explore niggas' own fuck shit. It's just whenever I talk to niggas about they fuck shit, it's like a 10-minute conversation. Like a nigga really don't argue me like down to 1,000. Cause my thoughts is like, okay, if niggas fix all of their shit, right? It has to be a unified front of fixing the traumas and issues. Cause niggas turn into white knights and fucking, you know, glorious, I am here for you, queen. But then you've never fixed your side. You think I'm going to sit there with you? Like, it helps the collective, man. I'm not even, if a nigga becomes these great, amazing niggas that y'all put in these memes, and then I show up and you still an asshole, you think I'm going to fucking sit, I'm out. I'm going to go find me amazing, bitch, because I'm amazing now. You didn't do anything.
There's a contradictory aspect to that as well in my mind.
Yeah.
Because when it comes to, I know I brought up Future earlier.
Mm-hmm.
I can appreciate Future, although he may do dirtbaggery and piece of shittery.
At least legendary level.
On legendary levels, but at least he's honest about it in his music. He never presents it as if I'm the knight in shining armor. I'm telling you that I'm a piece of shit. I'm about spending money, messing with lots of women, and utilizing whatever drugs I can get my hand on. Like, that's what I'm paying attention to. Even when you interview him, he'll tell you, like,
that's my fourth and fifth, bitch. I've been lying to him since the very
Honesty. Honesty. Not to say that I condone it, but at least he's honest. But you also gravitate towards that honesty and champion it. And you demonize other men for not being those type of things. But when you get the good guy on the opposite end, he must be gay, or he must be soft, or he this, or he that. He a beta male. He not an alpha male. Like,
I don't hear a lot of y'all talking about Leon Bridges. And Leon Bridges got a whole song out. And it's literally just like, yeah, bitch, you ain't really rub my back like you used to. I don't see none of y'all playing that. Like, you know, that nigga's whole song is like, hey, man, you really like, you know, treat me like I'm just, you know, a footstool. Like, that hurts. That hurts me.
We also come from an age of, you know, you can use me up.
And see, that's the thing. Like, that's really, like, the critiques. Listen, listening. Because the critiques is not about, it's just, I just be, because y'all just be, I think, are purposely dumb, because it just, the critique is, there's no way, it's like, you just don't, like, no, like, let's, come on, man, everybody's a thinker. If you look
are they really?
Well, that's what y'all be claiming. If you look at, use me until you use me up, this is a dynamic that that hurts all parties. That motherfucker's abused. At the end of the day, you're bored and fucking out here lonely because you've got the weakest individual on the planet. Not to say Bill was probably really that nigga, and he meant that song in context to, well, maybe he did, because niggas back then was just, the idea was to say whatever the fuck you wanted to hear. And maybe what you want to hear is horse shit, ma'am. Like, it's not about niggas not doing their part, but you got to, and really pick your part of the weight up. Like, well, I brought the 10. No, nigga, I need the 45. Like, I don't need the 10. I appreciate that you tried. Now go pick that fucking 45 up. Like, we lifting in this bitch today. Like, damn. Niggas is weird. What's wrong with y'all?
But that goes back to the pick and choose. The demonizing of one and the harrowing of another. Like, it's so much inconsistent. Like, if we're going to do kind of like what we talked about at the beginning of the show, as far as the predatory, statutory molestation of the youth when it comes to, you know, the pedos.
Yeah.
If you're going to demonize one, demonize them all. Don't you be inconsistent with how you're judging these situations. It's the same thing in relationships. It's the same thing in our music. It's the same thing of our acceptance of people's lifestyles. We're so inconsistent with how we approach these things because we're approaching it with
snap.
There's no such thing as unbiased. I believe a lot of people don't realize their implicit biases.
But, hey, this is how all this shit ties in. You go back to the why of what you're saying things. Like, you're mad at this person, and if it's stemming from fear, lack, get back, whatever the fuck, because I had a bad experience, and you're not essentially coming from the selfless space of I want us to be better. I want us to be better as a unit, as a people, then you have to take account of, yeah, this is how men and or women have acted for X amount of years, blah, blah, blah. But I can see how that is a problem. It's incumbent upon me selflessly to undo that part in myself. And in undoing that, the law of, we talk about attraction, but like law of vibration, like you're going to vibrate higher. And when you vibrate on the higher level, then that you attract that into your life. Like, you know, you match wavelengths. But that doesn't happen. Like, if you keep running around the same motherfucker, then essentially, nigga, that's your vibration is trash. And fuck how many degrees you got, how many, you know, sexy suits. Whatever the fuck you niggas are talking about.
I wouldn't even say it has to be you being around the same people, because you can be around the same people for a long period of time and you can still elevate. Like, the people around you don't always dictate your internal growth. But that asking of why is super important, because there's a lot of you out there that are really biased towards the LGBTQ community because your uncle touched you funny when you was little and you've been triggered ever since. It's a lot of you so-called hardcore rappers or hardcore street dudes that are mad at the Lil Nas X video because your celly was punking you when you was inside and he was making you wash his drawers, and you don't want nobody to know about that, but it's triggering you. Like, asking yourself, why do I have a bias to these certain situations, as opposed to hating on somebody, as opposed to like drawing a boundary? That ain't for me, but I also don't care to demonize it as well. You can accept any and everything. There's a couple of you out there that are trying to force these narratives in your relationships because you really don't like being by yourself. I'm trying to force this on somebody else and make them accept it because I don't want to accept it myself. Like, why are you approaching these things with an implicit bias? Find out what that bias is. Find out what a bias is if you don't know what bias is, because I'm not going to tell you on the show. Do you due diligence?
But and it frees you up. It doesn't necessarily free the person up. It's like, I don't like doing that. Why don't you like doing that? That's a simple conversation, like, with yourself. You could wrap that up in 20, 30 minutes at least. And it doesn't mean just because you found out that it all of a sudden stops that day, but it's like you can be aware of it. Right. Now you can, you know, all them fucking memes everybody posting with awareness. And now it's like, I'm irritated, but it's better because I know that I'm irritated now. And now you can just literally have a conversation in your brain like, you really think like this because you used to sit out back with Papa, like, you know, every summer. And he used to say them goddamn such and suches. And you just got mad at him for no reason. Because in his voice, he just was like, I don't like them on that goddamn TV gyrating. And you realize you really got no reason to not like motherfuckers that's gyrating.
I was just conditioned to hate them based on my upbringing. But you have to dive back that far to figure it out. You have to go inside your mind and really, like, unravel all these things that you think make up who you are. I don't like my girl grabbing my ass. Like, you just not like her touching you on your ass? Or, like, no, it's gay. It's
you
your girl, dog.
My booty.
Like, if your girl like your ass, boy, your girl like your ass. It's not, it doesn't make you gay because she likes your ass, but let me tear that down. I've been taught that this equals being homosexual, which is not true. If you're going to be sexual with the person that you like, that's between y'all, whatever y'all like. Nobody's saying that you have to identify as something specific because you guys have a certain boundary that you're okay with.
Nah, because when I have sex, I like her to lay there and understand that her power is what...
I like missionary all day long. Kind of what Roman Wayne say on, what was it, SmackDown or Raw? It's like missionary over and over and over again every night. It's the same thing. It gets boring.
And y'all gotta really understand why y'all like some shit or whatever. Like, you know, like, I like her to fucking, you know, I like a woman that cooks, cleans, and don't say nothing because that's peaceful. No, man, you in control.
Like, you like this, control.
Those are different things. I like, you know, I like to only fuck missionary. That's because you're insecure and you got control and she can't be, you know, dropping it on you because you'll come fast. Nigga, bitch, I came fast. Like, you know, I'm going to catch you next time. You was doing a good job, bitch. You doing a good job, bitch. You doing a good, yeah. Like, it's over. I didn't even tell you so that. It was good to me. Like, fuck it. You niggas is, it just, you become less weird with that. Like, every nigga is weird. Like, all of us are weird niggas to agree. You just the weirdest nigga on earth for knowing your problem and doing fuck all to fix it. Like, even back to that fucking statement. Like, women who was, like, amening that goddamn, like, yeah, that's right. Just plow my shit and I don't move. And it's like, ma'am, do you really want that? Did you even think, I just want to be taken? No. Because that thought came from, like, you wanting to be just your ego boosted. Like, that didn't come from you wanting to feel good. You know, no. That fucking don't feel good. Like,
dive back and see where that came from. Even for some of us. Like, I think we've talked
for
about
a
it.
A lot of us.
Well, I'll say as far as, when I say us, I mean men.
No, yeah. There, I mean,
there's a lot of men that I'm focused on, quote unquote, beating it up in one or two positions from the front of the back. But that's what I've been conditioned to believe in songs. That's what I've heard through music most of my life. That's how I'm supposed to beat it up. Or you start exploring yourself and you discover the internet and porn when you are in junior high school. And you see that that's what they're doing in the porn movie. So I think that that's what I'm supposed to do. And I'm like, you're conditioning yourself to believe all these different things. And then when somebody challenges that, it's like,
a motherfucking man.
How dare you tell me?
Be moaning during sex.
Yeah, I grunt. I don't moan. And if you don't shut up and let the noise out, if that's what you want to do, that's what you want. You can squaw. If that's what you want to let out, it doesn't matter, bro. Like, it doesn't make you less of a man for letting yourself be who you are. It doesn't make you less of a woman for letting yourself be who you are, sexuality-wise, persona-wise. Whatever it is, just, like, allow yourself to really be yourself. Some of you hate other biases because you hate the biases that you have about yourself.
Be weird, guys, you know, like, or
no, be weird.
Yeah, just be like the better version.
Yeah,
of
be the weird that encompasses all and embraces all and allows things to be what they are. Be a little bit more free in the situation, get rid of those boundaries and those chains that bind you. Be that type of weird. Like, I'm into different things. I am a black person that I also enjoy super black shit, but I enjoy anime and I enjoy goth shit as well. Like, whatever it is that you enjoy, enjoy all of that as opposed to being the weird where that's stupid because it's different.
Big goth titties.
Explain.
Big titty goth girlfriend.
Is that a category that you've researched?
That's the thing on the internet, like, just big titty goth girlfriend. I don't know why that became such a funny, like, meme, but
I don't know. I would have to look that up.
Well, go find you guys. It doesn't have to be goth. Just find you some. It doesn't have to be big titties unless you like big titties.
Whatever you like.
Yeah, go find some shit you like. Stop being a weirdo. The world could blow up tomorrow. You're going to sit here and not suck on some big goth and goth anime goth titties.
Find some things that you actually like as opposed to finding things that you've been conditioned to like. Who are you?
Bigger than sex. You like some shit. you think some shit that you're doing is goofy, but that's just what niggas do or whatever the fuck you. And it's dumb. It's super dumb. That's what women do. Who says who, bitch? Like, that's what niggas do. Says who, bitch?
Says who?
Do whatever the fuck you want.
Says who? Society says society doesn't know what society wants. Stop listening to them, because they're in disarray right now. They can't tell you which way is up.
Okay, see y'all on Saturday.